In this video, I'm going to review this metal case for a Raspberri Pi 4. Now, it's all metal, it has passive cooling, and it's inexpensive. So I'm going to go through all the features and let you know how it works. So when we open it up, you're going to see four raised areas here. And so what the idea is you put thermal pads on these four points, and that'll help to transfer the heat away passively from the four critical areas. The first one here is at the power chip. The next one is the CPU. The third one is the RAM chip. And the last one is the USB chip. Now it comes with four screws, a tiny little Allen wrench, and then the pads. And so this is very simple, and we're going to put this together. Now the reason that I bought this is because I want to make this astrophotography computer out of a Raspberry Pi. And I don't want a cheap plastic case, and I don't want a fan unless I absolutely have to, because I don't want it sitting there rotating and potentially messing up my images. And so I'm going to put it through its paces and run it and try and do a stress test and see if we can get this hot to see how well it really cools. So the first step is that you need to take out the SD card, because the SD card you need to put in later after you get it installed. So I just took that out. Now the next step is that we're going to put the pads on. Now it looks like they have some extras. That's good. So it looks like two of each. So I guess if you make a mistake, then you can go back. So I'm just going to lay this out and make sure I have these on here right. And I need one for the USB chip, which would be that one right there. Okay, so let's start from left to right, and the smallest one is going on the power chip. Okay. Got the power chip. Now the CPU is a little bigger. Okay, there's the CPU. Now the rectangular one is the RAM chip. All right, and then the last one is the USB chip, and that is in the middle. Okay, all right, now we're going to put this in like so. Okay. So you need to, here at the stereo jack, you need to put this in at an angle like this. I'll show you. If you put it straight in like this, it catches on the limb. So just put it in an angle, and then it'll go down there. All right. So we have holes for the SD card, all your ports here. And now let's get this and put this on and just flip this upside down. Hey, and they gave us an extra screw. How about that? So that looks pretty good. Now let's see if we can get our SD card back in. Okay. So if we look here on the side, they've got slots purposely cut out here to add a bit of ventilation. All right. Now here on this, this is all metal, and they have a grid here to have these act as cooling fin, which is pretty cool. So let's fire it up and see if everything works like this. So this has been running for a while, maybe a half an hour, over at my desk. I had a network cable plugged in. It's currently on because I've got running it off of the battery. I'll explain that a little bit later. And so it's warm. We can check the temperature. Back of the case reads 91. Let me see if I can do this upside down. Yeah, I got about 91 on the back of the case. Check the front. I'm reading this upside down, 94. And that's pretty cool. And so I want to go over some of the physical dimensions and some of the slots and holes and how it's all set up. So if we take a tape measure to this, this is going to be 3.5 inches in this direction. I believe it's 1 inch thick, about 1 1/8 inch thick. And then the width is about 2.5 inches. So it's slightly bigger than the Raspberri Pi 4. Now everything fits perfectly. You have full access to your network port and your USB ports. On this side, you've got your USB, your two micro HDMI, and then the audio video jack. That all works really well. And on the back, they even drilled a couple of holes in here to indicate the power and the activity light on the SD card. And so here is access to the SD card that works perfectly. And then this is a ventilation slot, as I mentioned before. So I paid about $10 for this, and so far it has worked great. I went into terminal and I checked the temperature of the CPU, and I'd have to go look at my notes to see where it was at, but it was running very cool, and it was no problem at all. Now, I mentioned the possibility of doing a stress test, and I don't think I really want to because I have to overclock it. But what I can do is that I can go back and I can put in all of my astrophotography gear and then run through a cycle, because I'm going to be using this as an astrophotography computer remotely. And to me, when I say that, I mean running by a battery. So right now it's being run by a battery. And I can test it under those real world conditions. But so far it ran all night long, sitting on the desk with no ventilation. Everything's just fine. I had the network cable plugged in, so it's sitting there periodically, you know, checking the clock or whatever it was doing. I wasn't browsing, but anyway, it seems to be working great. It's great. Everything works, and I'm pretty happy with that. So I'll put a product link in the description below, and then you can check that out if you are interested in the product.